Now, water and photosynthesis. So we have seen, so let's first recall the equation: carbon dioxide, water, light, chlorophyll, glucose, water and oxygen. So this is our photosynthesis equation. So we have seen the experiment for carbon dioxide. What is that experiment? Priestley experiment and Mohs half-life experiment prove that carbon dioxide is necessary for photosynthesis. And next we have seen the starch experiment, that starch is produced during the photosynthesis. So for everything we have experiments. Now we will see water is essential for photosynthesis. So how this experiment is given, very brief, already you have studied this experiment in the your 7th class. So we will see what is, once we will recall the experiment. So water is essential for photosynthesis. So water and photosynthesis, this was given by the Van Helmont. Okay. Van Helmont. Okay, this experiment you have already studied in the 7th class nutrition in the plants chapter. So let's recall the experiment once. So Von Helmont was a scientist who proved that water is necessary for plants for growing, for photosynthesis. So how did he prove that water is necessary for photosynthesis? So what he has done, he has taken small willow plant. He has taken small willow plant and kept it a large pot containing soil. So before keeping this plant, he has taken the weight of the plant, or he has measured the mass of the plant. He measured the weight of the plant separately and he measured the weight of the dry soil in which the plant is being kept. Okay. So weight of the soil also he measured. So at first, see, the weight of the willow plant was at starting 2.27, and the soil which is kept in the pot, the weight of the soil was 90.72, okay, at the start of the experiment. Now he has kept the plant, willow plant, in the soil in a containing pot. Now he covered the pot. He covered the soil with a plate having holes so that nothing should fall on the soil or something will add the excess weight to the soil. Means he has taken like this. See, this is the plant, suppose. Wait. So, this is the plant. And here, the willow plant something look like this. So this is the soil. This is our willow plant. Now, first, before keeping the plant in this soil, he has measured the plant weight, weight or mass, and also he has measured the mass of the soil also. So before that, the plant weight was 2.27 and the soil weight was 90.7. So he covered this here with a lid. He covered this portion with a lid having holes. So that nothing from outside could add to the soil. suppose some leaves or some dust may fall into the soil and it may increase the weight of the soil. So he covered the soil with the lid having holes. So holes to give, so that the holes, why he kept holes? Because it can absorb, the roots can absorb air and water through these holes. Okay, so then he covered the soil with the lid containing holes. Now he kept the plant outside. He just gave rain water. Whenever rain was coming, the rain water was taken by the plant. He did not give any additional water. Okay, just the rain water was only taken by the plant. He conducted this experiment for 5 years. For 5 years. After 5 years, he again taken the plant and measured the weight of the plant. So after 5 years, see, the weight of the plant was 76.74. Starting it was 2.27. After 5 years, it is 76.74. So what is the change? 74.47. So if you might subtract this from this, you will get this one. Okay. Now what is the soil weight? First, starting it was 90.72. So it is now 90.66. So soil weight is very, that's little change, small, very small change in the soil weight, and very large drastic change you observe in the plant weight. So starting it was 2.27, very small plant, it has grown now big, and now it after 5 years the plant weight is 76.74. so because he has not given nothing from outside, and nothing from outside is being added to the soil because he has covered the soil with the lid, so nothing, dust or anything will not added to the soil. So he concluded that, so only rain water was coming to the soil. So he proved that water is necessary for the growth of the plant. Water is being taken by the plant for growth. So for growth means water is necessary for the plant to prepare food. That food is being utilized for the plant, is utilized by the plant for the growth. Clear? Okay, I will repeat again. Listen. Von Helmont, scientist, chinna willow plant teeskunnadu. Starting a plant weight chusadu. Then weight enta 2.27. Matti edaithe a chetta pot lo pettina dantlo matti estaru kada, aa matti oka weight kuda chusadu. Adu entundi 90.72 undi. Tata 5 years conduct chesaru ee experiment. Aithe ee experiment conduct chesaru ee chetta pettadappudu pot matti vesesaru, plant pettaru. పాట్ మీద ఒక లిడ్ పెట్టారు, దానికి హోల్స్ పెట్టారు. ఎందుకంటే ఆ లోపల రూట్స్కి ఎయిర్ అందాలి కదా, సో వాటర్ కూడా అందాలి కదా అన్నట్టు చిన్న చిన్న లిడ్స్ పెట్టారు. ప్లస్ ఇంకోటి ఏంటంటే బయట నుంచి ఏదైనా గాలి, ఏదైనా దుమ్ము, లేకపోతే ఏదైనా వేరే ఆకులు అలాంటి పడితే సాయిల్లోకి సాయిల్ వెయిట్ ఇంక్రీజ్ అవుతుంది. సో మనం అలా అవ్వకూడదని, సాయిల్ వెయిట్ ఎగ్జాక్ట్గా ఎంత ఇంక్రీజ్ అవ్వాలన్నది తెలుసుకోవడానికి దాన్ని కవర్ చేశాడు. సో దట్ అడిషనల్గా ఏది యాడ్ ఆన్ అవ్వద్దు అని. బట్ కెప్ట్ హోల్స్, ఎందుకంటే జస్ట్ వాటర్ అండ్ ఎయిర్ రీచ్ అవుతాయి. ఈ ప్లాంట్ని 5 ఇయర్స్ గ్రో చేశారు. అయితే దానికి ఏమీ ఇచ్చేవాడు కాదు, జస్ట్ రెయిన్ పడినప్పుడు మాత్రం ఆ రెయిన్ వాటరే ఈ ప్లాంట్ తీసుకునేది. 5 ఇయర్స్ తర్వాత ఈ ప్లాంట్ తీసుకుని చూస్తే ప్లాంట్ అప్పుడు చిన్నగా ఉండేది, 5 ఇయర్స్లో గ్రో అయింది కదా. ఇప్పుడు దాని వెయిట్ ఎంత ఉంది? 76.74. సాయిల్ యొక్క వెయిట్ ఆల్మోస్ట్ సేమ్, జస్ట్ ఏ మైనర్ చేంజ్. సో దీని బట్టి ఆయన ఏం చెప్పాడు, ఓన్లీ సాయిల్, ఫస్ట్ ఆయన ఏమనుకున్నాడు, సాయిల్ ఓన్లీ, సాయిల్ ఒక్కటే నెససరీ ప్లాంట్ గ్రోత్కి అని అనుకున్నాడు. సో అది రాంగ్ అని చెప్పాడు, బికాస్ వాటర్ రెయిన్, ఎందుకంటే ఆయన ఏమి ఇవ్వలేదు, ఓన్లీ రెయిన్ వాటరే వస్తుంది. సో వాటర్ కూడా కావాలి ప్లాంట్ గ్రోత్కి. వాటర్ ఇస్ నెసెసరీ ఫర్ ప్లాంట్ గ్రోత్. ప్లాంట్ ఎప్పుడు గ్రో అవుతుంది? ప్లాంట్ ఫుడ్ తయారు చేసుకున్నప్పుడే గ్రో అవుతుంది. సో ఫుడ్ తయారు చేసుకోవటానికి ప్లాంట్కి వాటర్ కావాలి అన్నది వాన్ హెల్మెంట్ ఎక్స్పెరిమెంట్ నుంచి మనకి ప్రూవ్ అవుతుంది. సో దిస్ ఈజ్ ద It's fine. Okay, thank you.